Rocky Berry, number 7, will kick it off. The deep men are Wally Henry and Floyd Brown for UCLA. Here they are, and we are ready to go. What a knuckleball that Henry puts back up to the goal line and comes with it. The 14-yard line, maybe the 15. That's where they'll put it down, at the 15-yard line, and he really took a puck. They're down in 3 yards to go from the 20-yard line. UCLA's first offensive possession. The ball is given away to Go Fatter. Almost breaks it over the left side. Gets the first down as he moves it closer to the 30-yard line. And you can see from the information off the door on your television screen that UCLA was very prominent in all of the offensive stats for 1976. 3-5.
Looks like he's not doing very well in this first quarter.
Second down 10 from just short of the 35-yard line for Alabama. Leffler steps back, puts it in the air, and it is complete off the hands of the UCLA linebacker. It bounced off Raymond Burton's hands and right into the hands of the Alabama receiver, Ozzie Newsom. It is third down, and they need about a yard. UCLA now shows in a seven-man front, and they give the ball to Watson, and Watson puts over the left side. Gets just enough operating room to get the first down for Alabama. So the Crimson Tide sets up first down at the 46, and here's the defense lining up for UCLA. Second down and 5 for Alabama. Butler coming down on the option, turns it into the middle, gets to about the 46 before the defensive front, led by Frank Stevens, linebacker. UCLA brings him down. Some of the numbers on this UCLA linebacking core are most impressive, I'll tell you. Now they're finding the stubborn injury, taking him to the line. Ruby Hager just comes in there. It's almost a goal line defense here as they hand the ball off again to Watson. He tries for the first down, and I don't think he made it. It could be that it could bring up a field goal circumstance, but it is just enough. Just enough for the first down. Watson is way wide to the right. Newsom stood off to the left. Watson has to throw. Plenty of time, but all day, throws short. And the pass to Rick Neal, number 8, a sophomore out of Birmingham. Carries the ball inside the UCLA 35 to the 33. Leffler gives the ball to the first man out of the weak ball. That's Johnny Davis, the 228-pound fullback. He goes for another. Alabama first down. Third down, and it's close to 6 yards for Alabama. Leffler in trouble, and he goes. Jerry Robinson, the leading tackle on the UCLA team, fired and got it. And we're going to get it. Leffler will hold the longest for Bucky Berry this year, 47 yards. He sits out of 13 in field goal. He's got plenty of legs on it. Wally Henry is in motion. Douglas going down the line with the ball. Turns it in. He's across the 30. He finds what appears to be a first down before Murray Wright, number 19. A ball from Birmingham makes the tackle. West White is insulated against the temperature tonight, too. From the 35-yard line, Bankless wants to throw. Has Henry, but he's still left there. He's got only Bankless to beat. Can't get in, and it's touchdown Alabama. Bankless has Wally Henry open. Underthrew the ball, and very proud. Picks it in for the touchdown. Wally Henry now will back up on the goal line as Alabama leading 10-0 to kick off. Alabama having won the toss to start the game and chose to win. Goes to Henry at the 6. It's into the left. Fumbles! Alabama's got the ball! First down for the Crimson Tide. UCLA 31-yard line. Jeff Leffler hands the ball off to the fullback as Johnny Davis takes it down to the 21-yard line before Johnny Lynn can bring him down. And the Tide is rolling. First down. Just inside the 18-yard line of UCLA. It is Davis. And Davis is inside the 10 to the 7-yard line. This is the 30th time the Crimson Tide played in a ball game. First down and goal to go from the 7-yard line. Ball is given inside to the big guy, and he is down there to run. UCLA. Thankless gives to Brown again. And Theodis running it straight ahead, just out close to the 30-yard line. He may be just a little bit short of his first down. Third down and third field goal. And Thankless keeps it five, gets the first down out across the 31-yard line. On Christmas Day, ABC 5 World of Sports will give you a very special gift. Jim McDavid on second and eight from the 33. Thankless at the goal. He throws it downfield, Walker's out there, and he dropped it. Rick Walker had it in his hands, dropped it falling down. If he had been able to keep fire, he was gone. Did they call it good?
Yeah, I think they called it just the exhibition.
Here we again comes in motion. Thanks for back to throw. Some of the time goes down, he throws to the fourth man, the order crown. Brown is inside the 40. He's dragged down the number 92, Ricky Gilliland, but let's wait for the penalty call. So third down, number three. And the ball, on a straight power play to Tyler. Tyler was rolled back beyond the line of scrimmage by Gilliland and Harris. That's the yard, a fourth down. Thank you. And this is a very close, because somebody in that Alabama defensive front who should have anchored his legs. It might have been Gilliland. The two linebackers that come right into the down position, and I don't know if he made it. If he didn't make it. So we've got a whole new backfield in for Alabama. As the Crimson Tide defense is doing its thing. And Eichner, number 30, is sophomore from Atmore. And he can fly as he splashes over the left side.
I think we're going to see more running now because they are going into the wind. We're passing out the 35-0. And he's probably going to go out of the first to his line in the middle.
Alvin Culliver makes it first down for Alabama as he is stopped at the 48-yard line. Greatest first down for the five, well, at the 49-yard line. And over here, coming down the line, gives it to Culliver. It is Eichner, number 30, and Eichner goes down about the UCLA 41.
I was ahead so still Donnie and Christian Church was mostly receiving. I just thought it was a little long to make sure we didn't mess it up. But they did a marvelous job for me, and I'm sure they'll throw a great team for us over.
The face mask penalty, adding another 15 yards on here, gives Alabama a possession of the football down at the UCLA 21-yard line, first down. And we've got our special announcement for the offensive and defensive players of the year. $5,000 scholarship from Chevrolet.
Tony Mason now.
Thank you, Rose Henry. Got it? That should be for a first down. It is up at the 38-yard line for the Bruins. As the throw short, the field is found. Gets up to the 48-yard line. That will be close to another first down.
That's happened.
Third down and eight. Thank you, the throw. Gets it off. Passes to Mr. Walker. Rick Walker. He tries to stop, and he's out of bounds.
Oh, we're out on the field. The wind is
blue.
Is it a blue?
Yeah. Thank you, the throw. And it's the other side. Otherwise, you would have scored. Well, it really is. It's tough to compare it. The other ground, just one. Down for the back. The 14-yard line is with Mike Tucker and Mike Kramer, the free safety and the defensive halfback. Thank you. Turns it up. Oh, great effort by Kramer. Down to the 1-yard line. So it is third down from the one. Nothing there at the Tyler. Barry Cross and Mike Tucker, two timing. And getting yard and a half from the goal line. Right there's the ground. He didn't make it. for Alabama. And the tide is real hot in Houston. On second down and six from the 24, Mason on a pitch out, run down by Frank Stephen, number 41. Outside linebacker has penetrated.
They are very well known.
Touchdown for the Bruins. Run it. It's tighter to the sidelines and one goes skipped out of bounds. He has the 40 near the 37. Comes the board. Well, the ball is loose. Picked up by the other side. All the way back on the UCLA 49-yard line. As Hank was trying to pitch the ball wide to Wally Henry, as Henry was reversing. All right, Jim, it is third down at about a half mile now for UCLA. They'll try to go to the Alabama 35 to keep possession of the ball. They throw it over the middle. The pass is intercepted. Number 23, Mike Kramer. The free safety plays center field. This half is over. And it was a dynamite half for the Alabama Crimson Tide. And Houston now with four bucks. Henry goes in motion to the wide side of the field. And Bankwell takes the time around the option and turns it up. That is the most effective option play that UCLA has had all night, and it goes for big yardage. In front of him, there's a full point of his left. The Panthers, 24-0 Alabama lead. A blue start play of the second half. Bankless comes to the left side of the throw. Now he's got to pull it down and run it. Cuts it back just across midfield. He is short the first down, and as he is run down by Galenzo Hubbard, Charles Hanna, and Barry Clough. Fourth down and two. Well, why not? Now he throws it, and it is incomplete. And off is to the fullback, Johnny Davis. Wow. He hasn't had anything to leap for. But Alabama hasn't thrown the ball in his neighborhood. First down for the final at the Bruins 40. Right now they don't need to throw it. The Rutgers rolls out, little flip inside, it's Mason, and Tony Mason, who is a high school sensation in the Birmingham area, takes the field to the UCLA, 21-yard line for 19 and a first down. Sam Maddox, number 83, now in the lineup for Alabama, a tight end replacing Mason. They've got everybody in tight now, throw out backfield, hand the ball to Mason, cuts it back over the right side, and he's got it about the 13. So they're going to be looking at fourth and two, and that should bring Bucky Berry onto the ball game. Oh, it'll be close. Johnny Davis, big fullback, hitting in, and it looked to me like he just bucked right into Julius DeSoto. Alabama has been dominant. Good luck with the quarterback. Coming down the line, puts it out to Mason. Kick off him, touchdown, cover the flag, hold the ball. They had a foot. Rutgers again sets the throw, throws the pass, is complete at the 8-yard line to Fab Flanagan. But the Bruins jump on him and hold him, and so it's going to be fourth down. Bucky Berry comes on for a 25-yard field goal try. He'll hit it from the 15. Left hand block out of Rutgers hold. Bucky has kicked the 37-yarder. With 7:15 to go in the third quarter. Third and two. Bankless makes the pass. Delivers it. Got a man open. Henry. Wally Henry gets to the sideline. There he is thrown out. Guess who? Harry Strauss shoves him out. He has been all over the football field. Bankless straight back. As Bradley on the sideline. Throws it short. However, to the Otis Brown coming out of the right field. And the order goes for another UCLA first down to about the Alabama 35-yard line. He has two men over there.
Calling on coming this way. Calling on coming this way.
Bankless dropping the throw, looks toward Henry, delivers toward Henry. Wally leaps. Wally can't hold on. He was hit by Bob Smith, the freshman out of Fairhope, Alabama.
Well, he's got this one. He's got a lead of 27, I think. He
knows the thief. I'm not aware that he has to offer. On fourth and eight, Bankless pass, complete. And it's good for the first down to Homer Butler. So the play of Homer Butler with him was a good one. It was a UCLA first down at the Alabama 7-yard line. Bankless on a roll.
through.
Oh, that's
into the crowd. Looks like interception, but that came over top of
him. Intercepted, though, and I give up the interception.
Throws the burn Reese off of his pattern and makes the interception.
That could be enough for an Alabama first down as Tony Nathan carries it up across the 10 to the 15-yard line, and Alabama continues to dominate. First down for the Tide out of the 13. Here's Nathan. From making it 87 yards. First down for the Tide up at the 42. Leopard to throw. Throws for Newsom. Missed it. Another side. Levi Armstrong covering Ozzie Newsom. Second down. Tide. Leopard gives the ball this time to Watson. Goes to Watson, and he lunges to the 7. They'll be 2 yards short of the first down. Will they go for the touchdown? The indication is yes. Lucky Berry from, make it 28 yards, isn't it? Probably 28. Kevin Jones is holding. Doing five boys. Don't get there in time. So Lucky is having a good night. There are literally thousands of people in this community. The entire city of Memphis could make it work, and it does work. Franklin passes the throw on second down 8, throws it down. Didn't quite get away from Paul Harris and Bob Smith. Third down, Franklin straight back. Goes to the sideline. Somebody caught it, and apparently it was Dean Sessler who came down with possession. Simultaneous possession ball goes to the offensive end.
Well, UCLA has not made two so big plays that they've had too, and Alabama has in every instance.
Ball is given away to the other out,
and he goes. First up, set out right here. He's back.
There are no technical flags, and UCLA is on the board. There's somebody hanging on to his heel there for just a fraction of a second. Oh, nice. Now, well, hit. Football ball.
That's the way it's been for UCLA tonight.
All right, it's up to 16-yard line. Now, Valerie, first down for the Tide and Jeffrey Weir. And the Alabama running backs are still going. Lou Eichner, sophomore from Atmore.
But the most important statistic is on the scoreboard, 30-6, and the second is the penalty.
John Cole carries out to the 30. That will be an Alabama first down. The band turned in a fine performance on a day when the team didn't, and somebody said, well, at least the band looks like $1 million, and from that time on, it's been called the $1 million band.
Well,
but the team has certainly held its own tonight, hasn't it?
Oh, it looks like a million-dollar team tonight.
Third down and four, as a real close call.
Well,
didn't get much out of it.
No, that wind's still going pretty good, not as much as it did earlier in the game.
The football is whistled dead at the UCLA 42-yard line. It was a 24-yard punt.
Well, it depends on what the other bowl game is going to happen.
Right here.
Right there. That was. And we're trying to stop that whistle, and I think they've got to go to a 9-man punt. And UCLA has used basically an 8-man punt, and they've really been hurt. They were outside the level here.
That's Nathan. And he goes for the first down as he crosses the 30, goes to the 34 with a lot. But then Alabama had its problems with his games too. So I took a different patch on it and breaking up the squad and working people in segments. Here's over here to throw. Jack got all day now. Throws it down. That's a throw, and it is complete to Neal, the tight end. And Neal takes it inside the 35. Rick Neal.
One coach told me if you take away the middle of UCLA's offense, you stop them. You and Longhire and White certainly did that.
If you need some of those game things, you wouldn't all the time. I know that it's stuck in there.
Okay, thanks a lot, Scott.
Thank you.
I don't mean to ignore the ball game, but the time doesn't no longer about as Jack O'Rear has the Crimson Tide on the march again.
They're now down in the neighborhood of the UCLA 12-yard line, where it's going to be second down.
This will be quick.
O'Rear on the pressure. And the Bruins get it. He's going to enjoy a team with you in the 1976 college football season. This is Jocko Weir, heading the goal line.
Got him at the one.
With 35 seconds to play. And they have to pass the clock to move the team.
That play is very reminiscent of that one.
First and goal. And he cut down Alabama. As looked like it was Rick Watson who took it in. It was.
The nice things that happen to the winners. A little overcoat.
Well, it's fumbled. Michael Berry picks it up, throws it up for grabs in the end zone. Everybody's down in point, and it's like this. Look at Hill Malone. 36 to 6 with 23 seconds to play.